I am become death, the destroyer of worlds, said Oppenheimer. But of course, there may have been a metazoan who said it first. Sup, Earthers? Welcome back to D-News. I'm Trace. Ah, the metazoans, those early conquerors and destroyers of Earth. According to new research, these tiny animals may have caused the first mass extinction on our planet. Whew, what a relief. Humans are bad, and are likely causing another mass extinction right now. But come on, the metazoans did it first. We're just Johnny-come-latelys. We're number six. We're number six. Extinction is nothing new to our planet. About 3.8 billion years ago, life evolved, but it wasn't super diverse. It was mostly a blanket of gooey, single-celled, stationary organisms. Then 600 million years ago, during what's called the Cambrian Explosion, or Cambrian radiation, life began to diversify, and a new multicellular species evolved that was unlike anything we'd ever seen on Earth before, the metazoans. The researchers called these ecosystem engineers. They immediately began changing the environment to suit their way of life. Of course, at the time, there had already been life for 3 billion years, and that old life wasn't cut out for this new world the metazoans were building. During that Cambrian explosion, the older animals were pushed out of the fossil record as new animals evolved legs, backbones, complex eyes, and the concept of predators and prey, which we still see today. Thus, the first mass extinction began, called the end-ordovician or ordovician-silurian event, where 85% of species disappeared. But this wasn't the only extinction. Oh no! Over the next 70 million years or so, these new conquerors of the Earth enjoyed their reign. Another 70%, though, would die in the late Devonian extinction, about 360 million years ago. This was mostly in the ocean, with coral and other shallow sea animals dying off. Hypothetically, they were hammered by the changes in sea levels, climate change, or perhaps an asteroid impact. But a major theory says modernish plants may have evolved to suck more CO2 out of the air, cooling the planet and causing an ice age. This extinction removed the famous trilobites from the fossil record. Stupid plants. Then, 250 million years ago, more than 96% of the species that had evolved up to that point were wiped from the fossil record in what is called the Permian extinction, or the Great Dying. During the Permian, there were these synapses, sort of a cross between dogs and lizards. Picture the fin-backed Dimetrodon. These pre-dinosaur synapsids were one of the first vertebrate kings of the Earth, until this third extinction, where insects, marine animals, and synapsids were devastated, perhaps by an asteroid impact, acid rain caused by pollution from massive volcanic activity, or a sudden drop in oxygen caused by sea organisms affecting the atmosphere. Again, plants and animals killing each other. The fourth Triassic-Jurassic extinction started 200 million years ago, and since the loss of all that marine life after the Permian, cephalopods exploded onto the scene to fill that now empty space. During this event, more marine animals were wiped out, the reef-building coral that had spent hundreds of millions of years recovering was hit again, and the nights of summer, the cephalopods were hit really hard. The synapses that survived evolved into dinosaurs, but then were hit by the famous KT extinction event that wiped them out to 65 million years ago. Though we were already in trouble, with sea level rise and eruptions increasing around the planet, that meteor that hit during the KT extinction just accelerated what was already in progress. This killed another 3/4 of the species, including dinosaurs, flying petrosaurs, ammonites, flowering plants, and a few others. Whew. Today, everything that exists evolved from the survivors of each of these extinction events, and some scientists believe humans may have kicked off another mass extinction, the Holocene or Anthropocene extinction event. The sea levels are rising, atmosphere and soil, they're changing, and many of the world's species are disappearing. Knowing about these other extinctions, all this kind of sounds familiar. But only time will tell if we're in a sixth mass extinction. And in geologic time, that's gonna be a long wait. But we can rest easy knowing the metazoans did it first, right? Though I guess we are technically multicellular ancestors of the metazoans, so... Guys, we heard your comments, so we created a whole new show called D-News in Español. It's D-News, but in Spanish. You can check out one of the videos right here.
Es difícil para muchas personas imaginar la vida sin sexo. Pero la gente asexual también valora la intimidad física. Un estudio publicado en 2011 en la revista The Archives of Sexual Behavior descubrió que las mujeres asexuales sienten placer físico. Lo que ocurre es que no asocian esos sentimientos con impulsos sexuales.
Look, we don't have to freak out too much. Maybe there's a way to stop this sixth mass extinction. Will and Julia came up with some strategies right here.
So there's this idea out there that we only save the cute, cuddly creatures like the panda, or charismatic megafauna as they're sometimes called. Think of things like lion, polar bears, and whales. They're usually large or handsome or cute, and they need our help. These larger animals may be more at risk from climate change.
There's a lot of stuff to cover in this video. Do you guys think we should do like an extinction week where we look at each event on its own? Let us know in the comments. Make sure you subscribe for more D News. And thanks for tuning in.